want to tell you of a story of long ago of a man who owned a little store. I was mighty proud to have my name up over the door. This was some 2,000 years ago, as I recall. It was located in Jerusalem, you know, just across the street from Pilate's Hall. I had everything I thought a man could want. I can sell it. I can. Folks would come from miles around, regardless of the creed. But the only thing I had that I didn't think I could sell was in a shelf on a corner. Three old rusty spike nails. But then one day, a big Roman soldier walked through the door, and it seems to me that he shook the floor. "Can I help you, sir?" I said with a voice that seemed frail. He looked at me and he said, "I want to buy some big, big nails. I can sell." "Three old rusty spikes is all I have, sir." "Three for the job that I have. Three's enough. How much do I owe you?" He placed the money in my hand. Boy, was I glad to make the sale. Yeah, getting some extra eat tonight. Yeah, I get them shoes. I get the latest new gadget. I threw the money. Yeah, man, I told you I could sell anything. And I said, "Sir, what can you do with just three nails? Boy, I'm happy, man." He joins in with me. "Hey, you ever hear of a man called Jesus?" "That's yeah, Jesus. You know, I'm the one that goes about doing good. Healing people. Yeah, I know him. Woo!" Well, today, I intend to show the world that I'm boss. With these three nails, I'm going to nail them to the cross. You'll never know how I felt. I stood there almost numb. I got on my knees. I said, "Please, sir, what did I just do? I beg you, sir, I'm bowing back. I can sell." With them three nails, they nailed Jesus to the cross. Through the angry mobs, I could hear them saying, "Away with him! Crucify him!" I did that by greed, by lust, by sins. What about your sin? What about your greed? What about your love? We nailed him to the cross. We were saying, "Crucify him." How do we feel today? You can never know how I feel that I nailed the Savior that died for my sins to the cross. But he's there. He did it. We read in Sunday school that he was the propitiation. He was the sacrifice. He was the replacement for our sins. We don't have to feel that condemnation anymore. He did it because he loved us. Not because we loved him, but because he first loved us. Who is this man that was nailed to the cross? Listen to the words of this next song, and it'll tell you who he was.